way, and what's news around the world today?
Some wisdom skills along the way.
Oh, and a song to hum along with and sway.
Get your perfect entertaining start to the day
at 9 a.m. every weekday morning with
Mahima's
Good Morning Bay.
सभी लोग हमारे तरफ से एक प्यार भरा नमस्ते
नमस्कार
वनकम
नमस्कार
खुशामदी
सलाम अलैकुम
सच्चेकाल
निगंदर की वंदनम
जय स्वामी नारायण
जय श्री कृष्ण
जय जनेंद्र
हमारे इस्माइली भाई बंधुओं को बोल दे याली मदद
बोला अली मदद बोलते हुए सारे फीजी बंधुओं को बोले के नीसा बुला बनजन हम आ गए हैं आपके प्यारे महिमा के द्वारे मैसेफ फालतू बाबा
एंड ऑफ कोर्स मायसेल्फ फालतू रानी लेकर आपके लिए एक और ड्राइव टाइम दैट्स गोइंग टू मेक योर वंडरफुल वेडनेसडे totally glorious in Mastani Manjar.
That's true, but Manjar, and of course, first of all, let me remind you guys, it's COVID shelter in place day number 58.
Correct.
That means you still have to stay home, Manjar, not allowed to go home, schools are closed. We still are waiting to hear what the schools are going to be doing in the summer. All those things, Manjar, also fall, mein kya hone wala, we don't know, there's some disturbing news coming up on what's happening in the Far East, where the coronavirus actually, they supposedly had flattened out, and suddenly they're seeing a surge of all those things, Manjar. You'll hear more about those news items and you actually get into those for sure. And that's going to be on our news segment coming up pretty soon, Manjar. You can catch up in detail about the news we share with you guys on air on the news blog, mediamahima.com. That's why it's absolutely free. You won't have any kind of advertising disturbing you. It's content over there, right there. Go read it. And then what you can do is if you want to read up in detail about the stories, you can go to the links we provide you guys. And yes, that'll take you to places where the websites are trying to make some money by advertising and everything, Manjar. So you can actually try to ignore those ads and actually read the stories ahead in those things, stories in detail actually. And right now, Manjar, it's time for us to give you an update of what's happening in the roads. Iske liye jayenge hum log towards our raste ka hal, total saste mein.
It's time for the Bandhu traffic update. Call us from wherever you are at 408-912-2479.
Well, Manjar, it is still the COVID shelter-in-place traffic. Matlab, government of traffic on the roads. There's normal congestion at least. But accidents are nevertheless definitely there because people have been asked to get back to work. So obviously, people on the roads are going to be stressed out and everything, Manjar. They're going to have accidents. And also, here's something which is disturbing or blocking on a whole lane. In Alum Rock, on Alum Rock Avenue, and on 101 northbound, there's a traffic accident there. The left lane is blocked entirely in the region. So watch out for that. Again, San Jose May, one more traffic accident, which is our 101 southbound north of San Tomas Expressway. Second lane from the left is blocked over there. Or rather, it's not blocked. It's just affected. People are still moving around there. I see the camera. But the point, Manjar, is I think there is an accident there, so watch out, drive very carefully. Now, let's see. Other parts of the bay, everything is pretty much smooth. Normally, not much of things to report other than the roadworks happening in different places, especially on 280. Please remember one thing, 280 actually has long-term roadwork going on there. Watch out for that. And a disabled vehicle has been reported on 80 westbound, west of the Treasure Island Road in San Francisco. The right lane is blocked because of this, so watch out for the disabled vehicle there. Of course, make sure that you enjoy the beautiful sun, which we are getting right now over here in the Bay Area, Baljan. Yes, it's nice and sunny outside. Yesterday was gloomy. Today is kind of sunny. Kind of the wind chill there, but yeah, it doesn't seem like summer yet anyway. So, I don't know. Falthani, what do you say?
Really? It doesn't seem like summer to you?
No, it doesn't. See, I'm wearing a jacket today, Falthani. I'm wearing a vest.
Well, it was 57 degrees in the morning, but it's going to be
summer.
A nice 69 degrees.
It's pleasant. Come on, 57 is pretty pleasant, actually.
Yeah, that's true.
It was 55 when I actually got several of the husbands. But anyway, right now, let me tell you, we're going to go to Ganeya Kida, Falthani, and today's Ganeya Kida is from a movie called Agnipath. Agnipath.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Ajay Atul composition, Manjar, a beautiful song. Ajay Atul, man, they actually are musicians when it comes to emotional songs.
Yeah.
This really, gets that devotional emotion, the devotional fervor, I would say.
Yeah.
Right?
Like it builds up, right?
Correct, crescendo. And it goes towards the end. Listen to the song. It actually is the voice of Ajay Gogawal itself. Enjoy the song. We'll be back right after this.
ज्वाला सी जलती है आंखों में जिसके भी दिल में तेरा नाम है परवाह ही क्या उसका आरंभ कैसा है और कैसा dharta saaya tera deva shivanesha 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 deva shivanesha
I hope you enjoyed. Oh my god, Deva Shri Ganesha. Hey, when's Ganpati, by the way? Somewhere in September, right?
September.
Arey yaar, 2020, Ganpati ko bhi problem ho jayega. Bhai.
Kyu Altu?
There's still going to be restrictions on physical distancing, Fadwani.
Okay.
And given what's going to happen, oh my god, the news right today was crazy. But you wonder what's the news crazy, Bandhujan? You'll actually want to go to our news segment right now. And we're heading directly into that. And yes, if you want to catch up in detail about the news we share with you guys on air, you know what to do, right? Go to our news blog, mediamahima.com. And of course, Bandhujan, now this is where we share with you guys what's happening around the world, also in the Bay Area. And this is your news segment.
Well, before I get into the news headlines, I just want to share something with you, Bandhujan. This is with regard to the economy.
Okay.
The sale of pajamas are going up close Manujan, contact tracing is one of the best existing defenses that we have seen against the coronavirus. Anyone can do it if they've got the time and the tenacity. And now you can learn how to do that for free. This week, the Johns Hopkins Bloomberg School of Public Health launched a free online course on contact tracing for amateur sleuths hired to stop the virus in its tracks. It's required for the thousands of contact tracers that New York is hiring, but it's available to anyone who's interested. Contact tracing is a kind of disease detective work. Tracers track down anyone who might have been infected by a person who was recently diagnosed with coronavirus, so those contacts can quarantine themselves and prevent further spread.
Interesting.
Yes. How does it work? Well, you'll have to go to mediamahima.com. There is a detailed article that CNN has done, and we are going to be carrying a link to that article on our Media Mahima blog. You can go there and check it out. South Korea and China have started to ease up restrictions, right? But they have started to see a resurgence in COVID-19 infections right after the easing. Many countries have begun loosening up quarantine restrictions and reopening economies, including South Korea and China. But with a rise in cases, both countries are now considering new lockdown measures. In fact, you could go and take a look at how South Korea is now planning to not reopen schools because they want to make sure that they have everything in place before they see another resurgence of the spread. Canada and the United States are likely to be extending travel restrictions on especially non-essential travel until June 21st amid the ongoing novel coronavirus pandemic, sources in both nations said on Wednesday. The two neighbors had agreed on April 18th to extend border restrictions until May 21st as cases of the disease continue to rise in both the nations. Canada is now pressing for the measures to stay in place for at least another month until June 21st. It's too early to lift restrictions, so we're working towards an extension, said one Canadian government source, describing the talks with Washington as positive. A second government source said the discussions had been collaborative. In Washington, a U.S. official confirmed that the two sides were set to agree on a 30-day extension. On Tuesday, the chief Canadian public health officer said the United States, where cases are increasing steadily, presented a huge health risk to Canada. If you want to catch up on this story, you can go to mediamahima.com. Fed Chief Jerome Powell is saying that more relief spending may be costly, but it's definitely worth it. Additional government spending may be necessary to avoid long-lasting fallout from the coronavirus pandemic, Fed Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell said on Wednesday. Powell said the economy should recover once the virus is under control. But he cautioned that without more help, many small businesses would not survive that long, which is absolutely true, Manujan. There are so many cases that we're reading every single day. I would just urge you to go take a look at when Governor Newsom goes online, right? Mm-hmm. He goes live. You should see the number of small business owners who go on there and write in the, you know, look in the Facebook feed. You'll see the comments as to how many people are struggling. Mm-hmm. They didn't get the PPE loan, neither did they get the EIDL loan, and it's just heartbreaking to see how many people are struggling. And the PPE and the EIDL loans that were sanctioned under the first couple of stimulus packages seems to have gone largely to mid and large size corporations. It has not gone to the small businesses, is what people are arguing. So they're saying right now that that they definitely need more stimulus measures, and the Fed chair agrees. We ought to do what we can to avoid these outcomes, Powell said in a speech to the Peterson Institute for International Economics. He noted that Congress has already provided $2.9 trillion to prop up the economy, the fastest and the largest response for any post-war downturn, but said that more federal spending is needed. If for those of you who don't know, the Democrats are pushing for another stimulus bill to be passed. But of course, what they're asking for is also the inclusion of census information in that bill. Now, why is the census so important to all the Democrats, you might be wondering? Because the Electoral College is determined by what comes out in the census, Manujan. So if you haven't filled out your census form, and if you don't know what the Electoral College is, you know what, Aldo? We should actually do a small tutorial on what the Electoral College is.
Yeah, we will eventually do, Manujan. Stay tuned to our shows. Probably it'll be Good Morning BO. It might be coming up on our Pam Pam show for sure.
Yeah.
We actually learned something about civics.
Yeah.
Actually, civics, I'm talking about the civic, which is the part of the government.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. And why it's important for you to fill out your census forms if you haven't done it. In fact, they're going, there is such a huge push for it right now. Even in rural areas, the census forms are being dropped off at the doorsteps of, you know, even the remotest rural communities for people to fill out and keep it ready. They're trying to do it via mail. They're doing it via in-person, dropping it off. And also, they have the mycensus2020.gov, right?
Yes,
that's
online.
The website you can go
so
online.
Anybody and everybody in your household, whether they are legal status or not,
yeah,
it's good to be reported on the thing. And yes, it's not going to be used. Like initially there was a scare about how Trump was going to use that against people.
Uh-huh.
That's not something that's going to happen. Supreme Court actually has ruled against it. So,
right.
But of course, good to have representation because we need to have our say in the whole government per se.
Correct. Absolutely. Yeah. So as I mentioned, House Democrats have unveiled an additional $3 trillion spending proposal this week. And Powell said that the central bank would continue to use its own tools to support the economy, but he dismissed the idea of negative interest rates. That's not something that we're looking at, he clearly mentioned, noting that members of the Fed's rate setting committee had unanimously rejected the notion of negative rates. Let's see how Wall Street is doing after Powell's grim outlook. Well, Wall Street's main indices fell on Wednesday after Fed Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell warned of an extended period of weak growth and stagnant incomes due to the coronavirus pandemic. It will take some time for the U.S. recording. The U.S. economy to get back to where it was, Powell said in a webcast, and called for more fiscal stimulus. Powell's doing the right thing by warning people, and this is not just going to be a V-shaped recovery, said Sam Hendel, president and co-portfolio manager of New York-based Levin Easterly Ventures. And I think that the market may be overstating the ease of returning back to normal, he added. Which is actually true. They're saying that, oh yeah, we've got to ease, we've got to return back to normal because the economy will pick up, but it's not as easy as they say it is. Because a lot of people have been struggling and we've had almost a whole quarter of a shutdown, right? Yeah, we had a whole quarter of a shutdown. So in terms of numbers, as of 11:31 a.m. Eastern Time, the Dow Jones Industrial Average was down 307 points. Almost 1.29% at 23,457. The S&P 500 was down 26.48 points at 2,843. And the NASDAQ Composite Index was down close to 49 points at 8,954. Energy also dropped 2.5%, the steepest percentage losses among the 11 major S&P sectors. Interest rate sensitive bank stocks shed 4%, tracking a slight drop in the U.S. Treasury yields. So Wall Street fear gauge also rose for the second day to hit a one-week high. U.S. is accusing China-linked hackers of stealing coronavirus research. That's right, China-linked hackers are breaking into American organizations carrying out research into COVID-19, U.S. officials said on Wednesday, warning both scientists and public health officials to be on the lookout for cyber theft. In a joint statement, the FBI and the Department of Homeland Security said the FBI was investigating digital break-ins at U.S. organizations by China-linked quote, cyber actors, unquote, that it had monitored, quote, attempting to identify and illicitly obtain valuable intellectual property and public health data related to vaccine treatments and testing from networks and personnel affiliated with COVID-19 related research, unquote. The statement offered no further details on the identities of the targets or the hackers. The Chinese embassy in Washington did not respond immediately for a request to comment. China routinely denies long-standing American allegations of cyber espionage. That reminds me, you know, Altu?
Mm-hmm.
You see a lot of people, especially during this free time,
yeah,
people are putting up these TikTok videos. Guys, please be careful. I know many of you are having your kids, you know, your kids are doing these TikTok videos. I know it sounds very, very funny and it's very, very attractive. But then isn't every single thing like that,
mm-hmm,
before something terrible happens? Well, it's not just about your children being targeted, okay? It's not about the children being at risk. It is the fact that your entire data and security could be breached because they do not have a robust security, a secure platform. And the FBI has issued a warning against it. So please be careful when you're using TikTok, or if you have installed TikTok on your phones. Every single thing, it can track your offline activity, it can track your data. Every single thing can be breached.
Mm-hmm.
So it's leaving you vulnerable to hacking. So please be careful when you're using these different apps that keep popping up from all over the place.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go on over and talk about what's going on in India.
Please, I want to know more of what's happening with that thing. What's a three-year, what do you call it?
Yeah, three-year tour of duty. So the over 12 lakh strong Indian Army is finalizing a radical proposal for inducting youngsters for a three-year tour of duty tenure,
yes,
as both officers and jawans in the backdrop of the urgent need of for cadre restructuring amidst the ballooning salary and pension bills adversely impacting military modernization.
Yeah, that means they're going to add people more for service, right?
So, yeah. So what they're saying is this particular tour of duty scheme, if and when approved, will initially be launched with around 100 vacancies for officers and 1,000 vacancies for jawans. The feedback has been taken from the different army commands. There is general acceptance that this tour of duty scheme can be launched as an experiment with a limited number of vacancies. If successful, the vacancies can be increased later, the army spokesperson, Colonel Aman Anand, said. A senior officer in turn said that this would entail voluntary military service to mark a far-reaching shift away from the existing permanent service in the armed forces. It will not be military conscription like in some countries like Israel. With huge unemployment, India has no dearth of people wanting to join the armed forces, he said.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, so the army believes that well-trained, disciplined youngsters exiting the force after 1 year of training and 3 years of tour of duty at an age of 26 or 27 with a good amount of money in their pockets but no pension and other benefits will be lapped up by the private and public sectors for a fruitful second career.
Mm-hmm.
What an intelligent idea that is, right?
Yep, I really like it, yeah.
Yeah. There are youngsters who do, and of course, they're also prepared in the event India ever requires to rely on its, you know, defenses or its military to come through. Like right now, they're helping a lot.
India already had a very huge thing of reserve, right? Which is the NCC, which is equivalent to the National Guard. No, yeah, National Guard. Yes, very close to National Guard over here in America.
In America, what you're talking about, the NCC, the National Cadet Corps, is like the ROTC in America. It's called the Reserve Officers.
Just like, you know, they train to a certain level to be in the military, but they can always be called for active duty if needed.
Yeah.
If needed. But it's a very nice thing they're doing for all the, it's like a something to look forward to for all the people who are working in the military.
Right.
That's nice.
Well, and of course, you might be wondering about coronavirus developments in India. During a press conference on Wednesday, Nirmala Sitharaman, finance minister, said that rupees 20,000 crore subordinate debt will be provided to stressed MSMEs, adding that this would benefit 2 lakh such businesses. The MSME definition has been changed to allow units with investment up to 1 crore rupees to be called micro units in place of rupees 25 lakhs right now. Also, in a relief to taxpayers, the government extended the deadline for filing all income tax returns for 2019-2020 fiscal till November 30th, 2020. Meghalaya has not reported even one single new case of COVID-19 in the last 24 hours, while Daman and Diu, Sikkim, Nagaland and Lakshadweep have not also reported any cases so far. Nine states and union territories, including Chhattisgarh, Ladakh, Manipur, and of course Meghalaya, are all the people who have not reported any new cases. So, which is a good thing. And with the aim of scaling up coronavirus testing facilities, the Union Health Ministry has designated 14 health establishments in India, such as AIIMS, New Delhi, PGIMER in Chandigarh, and JIPMER in Puducherry, to review proposals for approving any new lab for COVID-19 testing in the different states. So if you want to catch up on all this and also the new rails that are being offered, the train services, 642 Shramik special trains are going to start from May 1st, ferrying home 8 lakh migrant workers who were stranded in various parts of the country as well. You can go to mediamahima.com. That's all we have for you on this morning's edition of Good Morning Babe and the Gem. We'll be back tonight live at 5 on the Pam Pam Show. Till then, have yourself a wonderful Wednesday. Stay happy, stay healthy, stay safe. We'll see you in the evening.